Mr. Heffron here, and here is a video on Newton's first law of motion, inertia. If you ever watch the old Bill Nye programs, they always start off with the saying, inertia is a property of matter. Inertia is a property of matter where matter has a tendency to maintain a constant velocity. It is resistance to acceleration. Inertia is a property of matter where, only an unbalanced external force can cause an acceleration or change in velocity. So for example, if a block of TNT was traveling forward at 10 meters per second east and blew up, then yeah, sure, some of the pieces will be flying off in different directions at like 1,000 meters per second. But if you add up all the velocities and masses, the center of mass would still be traveling at 10 meters per second east, because that's an internal explosion, internal forces. Therefore, it cannot change the overall velocity of the object. Okay. Now, here's an example where we do have an unbalanced force. So here we have the pitcher. The pitcher is providing an external force. So it's not a force from inside the ball, but outside the ball. The pitcher is going to throw the ball with 100 newtons of external force, accelerate the ball, and it's going to go from 0 to 40 meters per second. So inertia depends on your mass. More mass equals more matter, hence more inertia. Therefore, inertia can also be measured in kilograms, kilos. Light and photons are massless, so light does not technically have any inertia. So if you take a look at these objects right here, the car only has just over 1,000 kilos, the least amount of inertia. The monster truck has 4,500 kilos, so it's in the middle, medium amount of inertia. And the semi-truck has 16,000 kilos. It has the most inertia. So the semi-truck would be the most difficult object to accelerate or decelerate. Okay, inertia versus momentum. So inertia is often confused with momentum. It is not the same thing, but they are related though. Inertia is part of momentum, which is basically how difficult it is to stop something. So here we got a few objects. We got a fly, which is only like a gram, moving at 10 meters per second. We got a pair of people. So these people are 150 kilos traveling at 2 meters per second. And then we have a pachyderm elephant. It's not moving, it's at rest, just sitting there doing nothing, and it's 4,000 kilos. So yes, the elephant has the most inertia, it's the most difficult thing to accelerate or decelerate, but it's already stopped, so it's not hard to stop something that is stopped already. And if you look at the people, they may be slower than the fly, 5 times slower, but they are 150,000 times more massive. Therefore, to stop the people would be much more difficult than trying to stop the fly. Safety belts are a useful application of inertia. They prevent people from flying through windshields and onto the road during vehicle collisions. The belts provide a force to fight the person's inertia. So for example here, if you're wearing a safety belt and there's a car collision, after the collision, you're still going to be in your seat and you should be okay. No safety belts, well, then you go flying and you go through the windshield and it's very unsafe. Okay, in summary, inertia is a property of matter. Anything with mass has inertia, and that resists acceleration and provides a tendency to maintain constant velocity. Mass is what affects inertia the most. So more mass equals more inertia, and both mass and inertia are measured in kilograms. Application: seatbelts save lives by decelerating people who have inertia. Okay, and then we have a little poster showing how inertia works. All right, I hope this helps with your concepts and ideas and understanding of Newton's first law of inertia.